In the 90s, they revived big band swing music and had other ensembles following in their path. Big Bad Voodoo Daddy takes their audience back to a time in the 40s with their driving, pulsating, foot-stomping tunes, their suits, and their hats. The ensemble got together in Los Angeles in the early 90s, playing clubs and lounges, and were featured on the soundtrack of the 96 comedy Swingers. From 94 to 99, their discs included Big Bad Voodoo Daddy on their own record label, followed by What You Want for Christmas, before they signed a major record deal and released another self-titled CD, then This Beautiful Life. And also, You and Me and The Bottle Make Three Tonight. They were the only band to play both the Orange Bowl and the Super Bowl in the same year. And this is Big Bad Voodoo Daddy.
Now I'm the king of the swingers ball, jungle VIP. When I reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I wanna be a man of Bangkok, stroll right in the town and be just like the other men. I'm tired of monkeying around, so ooh, I wanna be just like you. Wanna walk like you, talk like you, hoodoo. You see, it's true, I ain't like me. To learn to be you, I meant to, yeah. Now don't you mess with me, man, cuff. Do what to do. Give me the power, a bench red flower, so I can be just like you. Don't you mess with me, man, cuff. Do me what I do. Give me the power, a match made flower, so I can be just like you. So, ooh, I wanna be just like you. Wanna walk like you, talk like you, hoodoo. You see, it's true, I ain't like me. You learn to be you, a man too, yeah.
All right, kiddo. Yeah. So, ooh, I wanna be just like you. I wanna walk like you, not like you, hoodoo. You see,
I'm pleased to be joined by Scotty Morris, Glenn Marhevka, both of Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Gentlemen, thank you for being here. Appreciate this.
Thanks for having us.
Let's start with why this music is so significant still in these times.
Hopefully it's good tunes. It's a good, I mean, people get nostalgic with the music style that's presented when you hear swing music, you know, because it's got so many layers of from the blues to jazz, the Dixieland, the ragtime. There's so much that encompasses in that music. So people kind of, they feel that it's a part of them. And then the music, you know, if it's done right, it really moves people like no other music I've ever seen.
Glenn, why does it stand the test of time?
I just think it's kind of a fun music. You can go out and it appeals to a wide variety of people, and it's interesting music. I think there's a lot going on musically. There's horns playing, there's, you know, guitar, bass, drums. I mean, it's a big ensemble generally, and it's just something that just is upbeat and everybody just kind of has a good time. They can dance to, they can kind of interact a little bit, whereas some other types of music, maybe they don't, you know, you don't really dance with a partner necessarily, and you just kind of like hang out. So I think it's just something, you know, that's really fun for everybody.
I'm walking through the casino heading back to my vehicle, and somebody comes up to me and says, "Litch, who do you have on the program coming up?" And I say, "Big Bad Voodoo Daddy." I say, "I know that band. I've heard that name. You know, I think I got that band in my mind's eyes, but I'm not quite certain about any particular music." Let me ask you, which tune would you select from the CDs that you think best represents you that I could pass on to these people? Or do you think it's a style?
I think as a songwriter in the band, I think there's probably, I always classify the music, and there's kind of got four different styles that we kind of tamp around with. We do one that just sort of encompasses everything from swing and jazz and blues, all kind of in one sort of style, which would be like a song called Jumpin' Jack. That song has lots of different elements, and King of Swing, I think, fall under the same sort of umbrella. And then there's songs like You Me and the Bottle Mix 3 and Go Daddy O, which are like textbook jump jive kind of songs. And then we've got songs like Maddest Kind of Love, which are sort of mid-tempo, more jazz influenced songs. And then we have songs like The Mambo Swing and The Jungle Book and I Like It, which are they're Latin flavored, but they're definitely, the rhythms aren't totally 100% rooted in that. There's sort of a lot of different styles going in. So I mean, one of the things, it's kind of hard to pin us down, because I like to mix styles within a song format, because I don't feel like there's any rules. Like, that's the one thing that we go into every song. We think, you know, I'll bring in a full, like on this new record, we're really working on a lot of early 40s blues and like New Orleans jazz, ragtime, stride kind of stuff. Well, none of us really are very, you know, schooled in that style of music. It's just a music we really love and we really dig. So, but I say there's no rules. This is just our interpretation of what has filtered through to us now. So it's pretty much, you know, all or nothing on those things.
This new disc forthcoming, I believe, in April.
It's it, yeah.
And what label?
It's going to be, we'll see. Uh-huh. We're negotiating a label deal right now.
How far along are you?
We're real close, yeah. Yeah, we're real close. We're actually going to go in September and start tracking. In about 2 weeks, we're going in to start tracking tunes. Whether the deal's ironed out or not, it'll come out under our umbrella any way we look at it. We want to own our own masters. We're tired of being under somebody else's lock and key.
Glenn, I want to start with you. We'll go over to you then, Scotty. What were the albums you first heard that made you say, yeah, this is the music I want to play?
Well, for me, you know, I listened to a lot of jazz music from like the 50s and 60s. I listened to like a lot of like Miles Davis and Clifford Brown and Freddie Hubbard and
the stuff on Blue Note.
Yeah, all the Blue Note stuff. And yeah. But you know, I'd been playing in like jazz bands, because when you're in school, even from junior high, we had a jazz ensemble. And and I actually remember when I think I was in about seventh or eighth grade, my parents, I live in Los Angeles, and we went down to Disneyland, and we saw at Carnation Plaza at Disneyland, they used to have a lot of big bands. They'd have like, you know, like Louis Belson and like all these different people, and they actually had Cab Calloway playing there when I was, I think it was seventh grade. And we went and checked it out, and I was just like, you know, my parents, you know, I didn't really even know who Cab Calloway was at the time. My parents did, and they just let me like go for it, and I just was like staring at this guy the whole time, and this giant big band was behind him. And I just had this huge smile on my face the whole night, and that pretty much did it for me. And I knew that I wanted to play trumpet, and I wanted to play, you know, jazz and big band stuff. And ever since then, that's like all I've, you know, I've been into that, just 100%.
So especially if you're listening to the Blue Note stuff, you must have been Lee Morgan is just,
Lee Morgan, oh man.
You, Scotty?
Yeah, well, the first thing was Cab Calloway and Louis Armstrong. When I was a kid, I had a paper route, just a little kid, and I would watch the Betty Boop cartoons as I was rolling my papers. And there was always the Old Man on the Mountain and Minnie the Moocher and those tunes.
Right.
And those songs, you know, when you hear a music, no matter how what era you're in, if a song kind of sticks with you or it sort of, you hear it and it feels perfect to you, that was the first music that I remember hearing that felt perfect to me. And then I got hip to Louis Armstrong really early on as a kid. It used to be around my house constantly. And then I remember now in 1985, I was going through these records, and there was a band called the Blasters from Los Angeles. They were a rockabilly American roots band. They were phenomenal, and they would come in and they would just destroy clubs. Well, the singer and the singer Phil Alvin and his brother Dave Alvin, great songwriters, they were a team. Well, Dave Alvin left, so Phil Alvin made a solo record, and he made this record in 1985 on Slash Records. It's a record only too. And I remember buying it because I was such a big Blasters fan. And all the tunes were all old Cab Calloway songs, Big Joe Turner songs. But here's the twist on it though, and like an Alec Johnson song from 1942, great blues tune. Here's the twist though, is he got the Sun Ra Orchestra to arrange the arrangements and play on it on half the tunes, and he got the Dirty Dozen Brass Band to arrange the other ones. So, I mean, could you imagine Sun Ra doing The Old Man on the Mountain or Brother, Can You Spare a Dime?
The orchestra, you see that?
My
getting into
goodness,
that.
It was the most incredible stuff. So in 85, I heard this stuff, and I was like, this is what I want to do, because I had loved that music all my life, and I started off playing trumpet. So here it is. This guy was like one of my rock and roll heroes doing this really great swing stuff, and I remember just... it just knocked me out.
We want to mention that Glenn, your trumpet player.
Glenn is our trumpet player,
and
right.
And your vocal and guitar.
Guitar and, yeah.
Right. What is it about this lifestyle that's appealing to you, gentlemen? I mean, specifically the big band 40s swing lifestyle. What is it about it that appeals to you?
I just think it was a cool time. I mean, you had big bands out there like traveling the country. I mean, there are tons of musicians out there. You had 17, 20 musicians on stage like every night, like all over the country. And I mean, it just doesn't happen as much anymore.
Ugh,
I mean,
you can't
really travel with a 17-piece band, unfortunately. But it's just, you know, I thought it was just amazing. I mean, if I could have been back there just checking this out and just, you know, seeing what was going on and all these amazing players that were just out there doing it, I mean, to me, it's just a cool thing.